So we are now in the morning of the 29th here in the States at least, and I'm at the end of my call, and I think my introductory videos are getting a little bit sloppy, but forgive me, I just don't have the time to be getting all these videos at home. On the other hand, I'm here to introduce a particular dish that is very popular among, well, at least the American folk here, and it's called lumpia. That's how they call it, lumpia. Anyway, there are many kinds of lumpia, and for now we're going to talk about lumpia Shanghai. It's a very popular party dish because it's finger food, and there are many ways of making lumpiang Shanghai. It's not even related to any Shanghai dish, because even so, if you go to the Chinese restaurants here in the States, lumpia is fried and it has veggies in it, with a little bit of meat if you want to, or shrimp, but then it's not purely meat or purely fish. Now, Mikey is actually in the vegetarian, actually pescatarian kick right now, and what that means is that he only eats at most if animals are concerned, meats is basically fish, but the rest is veggies, and so he buys all these fake meats, you know, like fake sausages and fake whatnots. But one of the things that he can eat is this, and actually he loves it very much. It's fish lumpia, so fish lumpiang Shanghai. So we're going to make this dish with fish in it, and in this case it can be any white fish. In the Philippines we usually use bangus or the milkfish, but here you can use any kind of fish, even salmon you can use. In this dish I used I believe flounder instead. It's readily available, it's a white fish, and very tasty too. So it's a very simple concoction, and I'll teach you how to make it and how to make sure that your lumpia does not unwrap away as it's being fried in oil. And so stay tuned and let's go. To make fish lumpia Shanghai, you need about 800 grams to a kilo of white fish fillet. This could be something like flounder or tilapia or the like. Traditionally, in the Philippines, we use bangus or the milkfish. What is important is that the fish fillets need to be sliced thinly in order to mix very well with the rest of the ingredients. Next, you need about a whole head of chopped garlic. Actually, this may be according to your taste. And some chopped onions, about half of a medium head. You also need a whole egg, some cornstarch, about 1/4 of a cup, and some salt and pepper to taste. Now that's just for the filling. For the crunchy outside wrap, we need some spring roll shells, which are thawed and separated into individual sheets, like so. Now we have everything ready, let's make fish lumpia Shanghai. Traditionally, the filling is combined and mixed together by hand. It is important that the mixing is a vigorous process involving lots of kneading and mashing using your palms and fingers in a roll and push motion, disintegrating the fish meat in the process. This results in a filling that is homogeneous and would hold very well. However, again, this is a very tiring process. So to facilitate, I chose to mix using a hand mixer, first at a medium speed to mix, then speeding it later to incorporate the ingredients very well. This mashes everything up. Once in a while, try to gather all the ingredients in the bowl while mixing. You will know that the mixture is ready once it is sticky to touch. Now, judging from the consistency of the mixture, this is ready for wrapping. The problem with lumpia or spring rolls is that they sometimes unwrap during the frying. In order to lessen this tendency, make an egg-based sealant by mixing a beaten egg with about an 1/8 cup of water. Now set this aside. Next is set the wrappers in front of you in a diamond fashion. Getting about a tablespoon of the filling, place it in the middle of the wrapper, and first getting the left and the right corners, fold until the edges meet in the middle. Apply some of the egg wash at the southern region of the wrap and then fold north. Then, apply more egg wash at the remaining open north-facing fold. Roll the wrapped filling forward.
sealing the spring roll very well. You may experience that you are one or two wrappers too many. If that happens, feel free to use the remaining wrappers with different fillings, like in this case, cheddar cheese slices with vegetable-based sausages. Once everything is wrapped, it's time to fry them. If, however, you choose to save them for later, roll each piece in all-purpose flour and arranging them in a parallel fashion, free to freeze them until use. With medium heat and using a pan that retains heat very well, like in this case, a thick cast iron and under shallow oil, fry a few pieces at a time, allowing some oil space to evenly distribute the heat. Secondly, to prevent the roll from unwrapping, be sure that the sealed side faces down into the oil. Because the filling is raw, it takes quite some time to cook the first side. As the first side cooks to half doneness, the liquids from the cooking will be released out on the opposite top side. This takes about 1 or 1.5 minutes. Once this is reached, turn over to fry to the opposite side. Now this takes about another minute. It is this that ensures your lumpia Shanghai is fried to proper doneness, meaning the filling is cooked and dehydrated to prevent further leftover juices from escaping to an excess, making your lumpia soggy. Now, sometimes liquid fillings may escape as well, as in this case from the cheese used from the other lumpia flavor we made with cheese slice and sausage. Now, as you can see, it is fried to just proper brownness and crispness. It is time to drain and rest your lumpia for about a minute or so. Serve it with sweet and sour sauce or some ready-made Thai chili sauce on the side. Dip the lumpia and take a bite. Delicious and truly worth the effort.